around here, the light is so clear, you can see for miles and miles. There's nothing stopping you seeing the full sunrise, the full sunset, the full galaxy of stars at night. It's so clear, you don't have any light pollution. It's just natural, everything that you see. There's nothing in the road of taking the picture that you want. Yeah, it's wonderful. The landscape is just so vital to everything I do. I don't paint anything that I haven't seen or taken the photo myself. I'm always on the lookout of the things I can see. I take photos of them really quick before the light changes, or I think, oh, that's really interesting. Get a photo, and you might not use that photo, or you might use it several years down the line, but you've got that reference of what is possible to do, what light that you saw on that day. Colour influences what I do immensely. For instance, the painting I did, Evening Glow, where the light catches on the trees at a particular time of day and they just light up reds and bright cream colours. That's the light, and the colour is what caught my eye. It's always the colour that gets me started and that I want to reproduce it. When I did the sunrise painting, that was one morning I opened the curtains and I could see this magnificent sunrise happening. So I quickly got dressed, grabbed the camera and ran out there, out the back. And I just kept taking photos as it changed and it got brighter and brighter and brighter. And within 2 days, I had my painting done. It had captured my imagination so strongly. I got that painting done. I've lived here. My family bought a farm just over there when I was 10 weeks old. I married the boy next door and moved down the road to here. So yeah, you could say I was local. This one is Sunshine Harvesting. That's my father on the International Crawler Tractor and my grandfather on the Sunshine Harvester. And that's in 1956 when it was a very wet harvest. So Dad had to buy the International Crawler just to be able to harvest the rice. And so my grandfather's on the back there at the bagging out chute. The bags are collected on the where he's standing, and then they would stop every now and again and set all the bags down all in the one position and off they go again. The Sunshine Harvester I grew up with in the shed. Dad had stopped using it by that time and got a contractor instead. But there was always a connection to it, and you could see the sunshine stamped on the metal on the drum up the top, and it was just, it's evocative. And then when I found this picture of Dad and my grandfather together, I knew that I wanted to paint it. So it's only a very small black and white picture like they were in those days, 2 inches by 3 inches or something. So I had to spend a lot of time figuring out exactly what it was I was looking at. So I spoke to my brother-in-law, I spoke to my brothers, spoke to anybody else who might have any experience at all with the Sunshine Harvester, and managed to figure out what all the various parts were, because I knew if I was going to paint it, it either had to be just a hint at it, or I had to do it properly, because there'd be plenty of people around who told me I did it wrong. So part of that thing was I learnt a lot about colour by figuring out what colour each thing must have been from the tonal shade of the black and white photo. I learnt not to use white to lighten something because it would just go totally off. So for the darker colours, for the darker red to lighten it, I actually added a greenish yellow, and that brought it back down to more the correct tone for what I was needing to paint on what part of the tractor or the harvester. And the colour in the sky, I completely made it up. It was really quite very indistinct what was in the sky. So I chose a modern day sky that looked kind of like there might have been rain in the last few days. And that's why I've painted the clouds how they are. It's really special to be able to have the privilege to live here and have those things available. Every painting I do, I learn something new and incorporate that in the next one. Continual learning it is. To be able to improve every time and identify in what area I've improved. Not necessarily, I didn't start out wanting to get better in that area, but at the end, by doing research, looking at other paintings, mixing your colour again and again if it didn't quite work, you find that you've learnt something you weren't expecting. And yeah, it's really, it enriches your painting and gets you so much better. And another thing I like to do is share that knowledge. So if I've been to a workshop or if I figured something out by reading a book or whatever, I like to share that with everybody that wants to listen, and maybe they don't hear it anyway.